a great misunderstanding about the nature of political involvement, especially in the United States. It applies everywhere, but especially in the United States, because we're often told that Christians don't have a place in politics, that we're supposed to be separate and outside. That idea came from a group of thinkers called the Gnostics that tried to separate things into a holy set of things, the church and doing God's work, and a not holy set, a worldly set of things that you're really not supposed to be involved in. But that's really not the case. You have to look at what God says about these things. And if you go to Daniel, Daniel told us specifically that God lifts up kings and puts them on their thrones and dethrones them at will. This is something the American people really have to ponder, because in America, for the first time in history, you have God choosing a sovereign, we the people. See, in the United States, with the system that we have, it's not the president that's the sovereign, it's not the Congress that's the sovereign, it's not the Supreme Court that's the sovereign. It literally says, we the people, in order to form a more perfect union. For the first time in history, God made a people, the American people, the sovereign of a nation. So the question of whether Christians should become involved in politics really doesn't make sense. Whether you like it or not, God's made you the sovereign of a nation. You are involved in politics. And the question is, are you going to be active about it, or are you going to be passive about it? Can you stand in front of Him one day and say, I'm proud of the work I did in the position you gave me?